progressive protesters are against Mark Zuckerberg because of the fact that he's now getting a little political. Now, he hasn't been political, he hadn't been political before, but all of a sudden he's putting together these fundraising events. And the first politician that he fundraised for was New Jersey Governor Chris Christie.
Damn drums.
So you can understand why progressives are unhappy about this, especially when it comes to Chris Christie's record on defunding Planned Parenthood. Mm. So that's a specific issue that these progressives were focusing on. And of course, Credo was one of the organizations that was behind this protest. They actually showed up to Mark Zuckerberg's home while that fundraising event was happening, and they were protesting there. Now, Chris Christie had cut funding for Planned Parenthood by $7.5 million. And of course, he did so by saying, look, we want small government, but you know what? That small government shut down a few clinics in the state of New Jersey. Mm-hmm. Okay, so there's a huge problem there because, of course, as you guys all know, and we've said it over and over again, Planned Parenthood is not just about abortions. That's literally 3% of what they do. There are screenings, STD tests, contraceptives, everything that you can imagine that women, well, not everything that you can imagine, but a lot of the preventative screenings that women need are provided there.
Right. Now, look, you can pick a lot of different issues to fight Chris Christie on. Now, he's got a lot of love recently because of what happened with Superstorm Sandy, and so he's very popular in New Jersey because of that. He seemed to have a bipartisan air about him because he praised Obama's response to that. Now, of course, earlier he'd done a huge convention speech about how Obama was terrible and should definitely not be reelected, etc. He's got a lot of good hype behind him, but the reality is, and part of why Zuckerberg is throwing this fundraiser for him, is because Chris Christie is the best representative of the rich that there is in this country.
Yes, that's what it's really about.
He cuts viciously from the state budgets to the point where Camden and Newark had to fire large parts of their police force, and crime skyrocketed in those places. But who cares? It's Newark and Camden. Chris Christie doesn't have any donors in Newark and Camden, so he doesn't give a damn. And what did he use the extra money for? He used it for tax cuts for the rich and for corporations. And we've covered this story before. He said, no, it was so that they can create jobs. And all the companies, a lot of the companies that got those tax cuts, did they create jobs? No, they cut jobs in New Jersey. And Chris Christie took away a tiny percentage. Like one example I remember, I think it was Campbell's Soup, that they got $42 million in tax breaks for hiring people. They fired about 100 people. And Chris Christie said, I can't believe you fired them instead of hiring them. Mm-hmm. All right, you only get $38 million or $34 million in that ballpark, right? So.
No, Chris Christie, I mean, I feel like, you know, he has a veneer, right? And the veneer is like this likable guy, you know, he jokes about his weight on late night shows, and he seems like the kind of guy you'd want to have a beer with, right? And that's a bit of a cliche now when it comes to politics. But people who aren't necessarily in the political world will look at him and say, he's a likable guy, yeah, it's fine. I mean, you have to do a lot of research to really figure out what he's doing to destroy his own state.
If you remember, Christopher Dorner, the killer in L.A.,
yeah,
said, I like Hillary Clinton, but, you know, second of all, I like Chris Christie. That makes no sense.
None at all. Right? They're on two opposite ends of the spectrum.
But he doesn't know that much about politics, so he seemed like that Chris Christie, yes, was a likable guy. Now, look, the rich absolutely love Chris Christie. Why? Because a lot of them in New York, and by the way, in Silicon Valley, of course, as Zuckerberg is, are socially liberal. They don't hate gay people. They don't hate black people. They're educated, and et cetera, et cetera. But they want the money, Lebowski. They want to keep their money. They hate taxes. So they're like, no, my God, give education to other people? Give them an opportunity? No, I want the money. I want the money.
Okay.
So who's the best guy who's going to not be too socially conservative and give you the giant tax cuts while pretending to be a regular guy? Chris Christie. His top donors are hedge fund guys, and now all the Silicon Valley billionaires are like, yeah, let's ride that gravy train.
Now, Zuckerberg's communication team, of course, responded to this, and they said, look, this has nothing to do with taxes or anything that we're mentioning on the show.
No, of course not.
This has to do about the education in New Jersey.
And if
you can remember, Mark Zuckerberg did donate a significant amount of money to New Jersey public schools, okay?
Yeah, that was when he was having some PR trouble, mm-hmm, and then he's like, I don't know, I give $100 million to Newark schools.
Yeah. But here's, and he did give $100 million, but here is what the reality is, okay? the education system, or what Chris Christie wants to do with the education system in New Jersey, is a complete and utter disaster. He's in favor of the vouchers, which of course on the surface look like it's a great idea, but basically it sucks the money out of public education, so then public education fails, and then you use the vouchers to encourage parents to send their kids to private schools, right? So then if you privatize the education and then you don't have a public option for education, you think the government's gonna help you out with those vouchers? Hell no, they're not. Okay, so you're screwed. You're gonna have to pay for education. If you can't afford it, it's too bad. Your kids can't get it.
Besides which, when you privatize it, corporations that fund those politicians make more money. And by the way, unfortunately, a lot of the wealthy in the country already send their kids to private schools, so they think, why am I paying property taxes that are going to public schools that my kids don't go to anyway? So if we wind up kiboshing those schools, I save a little bit of money.
Exactly.
And then look, my kids are in private school. Private schools are great.
You know, my parents, at one point, they were extremely poor. We had to depend on certain social services to make ends meet, right? And because of that, I'm able to be where I am today. And I feel like it is my duty to give back to the country. So I don't care. If I'm wealthy enough to send my kids to private school, so be it. But I would be happy to make sure my property taxes go toward education to give other kids an opportunity.
There's only one thing you're wrong about. There is something slightly more unpatriotic, and that's what Facebook co-founder Eduardo Saverin did.
Yes.
Which is, he literally ripped up his U.S. passport, said, "What, America? I don't give a shit about America. I'm in Singapore now. I don't want to pay your stinking taxes." He did it before the IPO so he could avoid taxes. And of course, what happened? People like Rush Limbaugh and Fox News defended him because they don't give a damn about being patriotic or American. They're like, oh, you, because what they pray to and what they really are loyal to is money, the money god, right? So like, they're like, Saverin betrayed the country in a sense by, you know, by leaving it. I don't care about Saverin. I don't see this like some big betrayal of me or the, but like,
it's just symbolic.
But it's like, he's literally couldn't be more unpatriotic, right?
I know.
And Limbaugh celebrates it. Fox News celebrates it because he's patriotic to the one thing they care about: money. And that's what this fundraiser with Zuckerberg is about. It's about, this Chris Christie guy will funnel more money to us.
Yeah.
So, and it's funny, they report on Condoleezza Rice was there. Of course, she's up at Stanford, right? And then they said a whole bunch of young guys in really fancy cars were at the fundraisers.
Yeah, like Lincoln Town cars and stuff like that.
Because it's all the Silicon Valley guys who are young tech guys who are all millionaires, billionaires. They're paying $3,800 a person for this meal. And half the money went for Chris Christie's food. So it was kind of a waste.
Oh, zinger!